Hi guys, this topic about surgical treatment of intractable BPPV. This term coined by Diskolpak in 1952. BPPV is the common cause of peripheral vertigo and overall vertigo. In vestibular system, there are two systems. One is semicircular canal, second is otolithic organ like utricle and saccule. The utricle and saccule having macula and semicircular canal having cupula and the ampulla. So these two systems are responsible for vertigo. The common canal involvement is the posterior semicircular canal about 90% of cases, horizontal semicircular canal about 5% of cases, multiple canal and superior canal involvement 2%, multiple canal involvement is about 1%. Posterior canal, there is upbeating torsional nystagmus. Superior canal, there is downbeating torsional nystagmus. In horizontal canal, there is horizontal nystagmus. So you can easily find out in canal maneuver or Diskolpak maneuver the classical torsional nystagmus in BPPV to diagnose it. It is mainly clinical diagnosis. What is refractory BPPV? It is persistent spell of disabling positional vertigo of frequent recurrences that are refractory to repositioning maneuvering and repeated exercises in bent rib exercise failure are called refractory BPPV. There are two types of surgery in posterior semicircular canal BPPV. The transection of the posterior ampullary nerve is called singular neurectomy, also called Gay-Sachs singular neurectomy. Second surgery is semicircular canal occlusion. Mostly posterior semicircular canal is responsible, so it is posterior semicircular canal occlusion by transmastoid approach. In Gay-Sachs neurectomy, which discovered in 1974, if you elevate the tympanometal flap and you have to drill the floor of the round window near the posterior superior portion of round window, and in the depth of 1 to 3 mm you find the singular nerve. You can cauterate, bipolarate or cut it. So this is the simple method, but sometimes it's difficult to find the singular nerve in that location. Second surgery, posterior semicircular canal occlusion. You can drill the posterior semicircular canal transmastoid approach meticulously so that there will be no hearing loss. And after exposing the periosteum and membrane, just you have to plug with bone dust, fascia or muscle. So this is posterior semicircular canal. For us, it's very easy to do posterior semicircular occlusion, but because we are routinely doing the transmastoid approach. So both techniques are very good. Efficacy is about 97% in refractory BPPV. So this is the plugging of posterior semicircular canal by fascia, and this is the classical Gay-Sachs neurectomy, and the just posterior superior, near the posterior superior margin of the round window niche. So this is BPPV refractory cases. We require two type of surgery: semicircular canal occlusion and Gay-Sachs neurectomy. So these two type of surgery sometimes very rarely required. Now some talk about what is BPPV. BPPV is most common cause of vertigo. It's found in about 1.6% of the population and more commonly in the female than the male, and commonly in the 50 to 70 year of the age. The Harold Suknes given the theory of canalolithiasis and cupulolithiasis theory given by the Hollenhout et al. The most common canal involvement is the posterior semicircular canal. Because of otolith or otoconia, which are supposed to found in the utricle, are coming in the any semicircular canal leading to vertigo because of stimulation of the kinocelium of the hair cells, which ultimately stimulate the vestibular nerve, leading to vertigo. This autoconia are calcium carbonate crystals, so in abnormal position leading to vertigo. The vertigo BPP is two type. Idiopathic primary, there is no reason found. In secondary, because of trauma or viral infection, the autoconia size is about 0.5 to 30 micrometer. So if free floating autoconia are there, that is called canalolithiasis. If they are attached to the cupula of semicircular canal, this is called cupulolithiasis. If you see in posterior semicircular canal, there is upbeating torsional nystagmus. In horizontal canal, there is horizontal nystagmus, and superior canal, there is downbeating nystagmus. So these autoconia in abnormal location lead to the vertigo, which is short duration and on positional changes. So this short duration, less than 20 second short duration vertigo, is called BPPV. The diagnosis of BPPV mainly disc hole pipe maneuver for superior canal and posterior semicircular canal. You can do roll test for the horizontal semicircular canal. The repositioning maneuver for posterior and superior canal are same, like apply maneuver, cement maneuver, brand of exercise, 360 degree rotation you can do in this. For horizontal semicircular canal, there is 272 Warwick roll, there is your rotation 360 degree, and there is Guffoni maneuver. So these are the for the horizontal semicircular canal. For superior semicircular canal, the same, you can do simple apply maneuver, and these are the head rolling maneuver also you can do in the superior semicircular canal, or head hanging maneuver. So for superior and posterior semicircular, the maneuver are same, because right anterior is in the plane of the left posterior semicircular canal. Same is there, the left anterior in the plane of the right posterior semicircular canal. So these are the commonly asked question in the questions all in BPPV. Thank you so much.